Welcome to Turbo Tips, where we get the top tips on a trending topic from YouTube's hottest creative talent. I'm Jen McKinnon, and in this episode, we hear from music video mogul Josh Olufemii, the ever-vibrant premiere gal Kelsey Brannon, and veteran of video editing tutorials Nathaniel Dodson from Tutvid for their top video editing tips. This video is brought to you by Envato Elements, a subscription-based library full of digital assets to help you get your creative projects done. Check the link below for a special offer from the Envato team. The first of our tip masters is Josh Olufemii. Josh is the director of Olufemii Studios, where he produces high-end music videos, commercials, and branded content. He then takes his industry knowledge and expertise and packages it up to share with his followers on his self-titled YouTube channel. There you'll find post-production tutorials, production breakdowns, and interviews with industry veterans and up-and-coming creators. Josh has put together a really useful tutorial for you on transforming standard opaque text into professional titles or lower thirds. Here's Josh.
How's it going, Envato fam? This is Josh Olufemii, live from LA, and I run the YouTube channel of the same name. Have you ever seen an incredible video only to have it completely ruined by crappy lower thirds or horrible opening titles? It's probably because the default text in the Adobe suite just in general looks like a flat and fake overlay that just rests on top, almost hovering on top of the footage. In this video, I'm going to teach you four ways how to make your titles not to suck in After Effects. First, I'm going to quickly tell you what they are, and then I'm going to show you actually how to do this. Number one, you got to choose the right font. I like to use a thick and bold font, such as Futura PT Bold. Number two, you can add gradient to add depth. Number three, you can add noise to add realism. And number four, you can add movement and maybe even a reveal to add a bit of dynamism. All right, guys, it's time to go into After Effects. All right, we are now in After Effects. We're going to create a new composition. Let's name it text. We'll have the width be 1920 and we'll have the height be 1080. Click OK. Let's now drag the background footage into the composition. I have some footage of New York. Let's go into the footage and go into the transform tool and let's scale it down so we're not zoomed in at all. Then we're gonna go to the text tool and we're gonna create a text box. We're gonna make the text big to start out. And let's type in New York City. As you can tell, I have Future PT as the font and then I have bold as the qualifier. The thing about text in Adobe is, in general, it just looks like normal text, which looks flat. It looks like a cheap fake overlay on top of the footage. And what we're gonna try to do is we're gonna actually try to make this text look like it's actually baked into the footage. The first way we're going to do that is just by adding a little bit of depth to the text. We're going to do that by actually making a mask. Let's go over to the rectangle tool. Make sure that you're actually clicked onto the text. And then you're going to draw a rectangle mask over the text. And then you're going to click into the mask and we're going to adjust the mask feather. Go back to the selection tool. What we're trying to do is we're just trying to basically feather the text so it's a little bit darker on the edges and a little bit more transparent on the edges and a little bit more opaque in the middle. And you see a gradient. I'm going to adjust that just a little bit. There we go. This already looks a lot better. It goes from dark, bright to dark. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to actually incorporate noise into the text. Any footage that you have will have some amount of noise in it, whether it's extreme or less extreme. The reason why this text looks like it's just sitting on top of the footage is because the text usually does not have any noise because it's just a clean digital asset. So we almost have to add imperfection back into the text by adding noise. So we're going to go into effects and presets. If you don't see this panel right here, just go to window. And then make sure that you have effects and presets checked. In here, we're gonna type noise. And we're gonna bring that over onto our text. And let's adjust the amount to our liking. It's pretty good. It's like 44. Let's bring it down to 35. It's pretty cool. You can already see a little bit of that noise. Last thing that we're going to do is we're going to add a little bit of movement and then maybe even adding a reveal to the text. And this is how we're going to do that. We're going to do that by going over to transform and position. We're going to create our first keyframe by clicking on the stopwatch. Keyframe is automatically created. Then we're going to go ahead and we're going to create another keyframe. And we're going to move the text over just a tiny bit. Keyframes, if you don't know, are basically how you change an effect over time. So from this keyframe to the next keyframe, we're going to actually move the position of the text from one place to another. Alrighty, now for the reveal. What we're going to do is we're going to click on the text and we are going to pre-compose. Make sure that you move all attributes to the new composition. Make sure that's clicked. Click OK. And we have a pre-composed layer, and inside that layer is the text. We're going to then create another mask around everything. We're going to go into the mask, and then we're going to keyframe the mask path. Create two keyframe points. The first keyframe point, let's go to the selection tool. We want the mask to be completely off of the text. And the second keyframe point, we want to be completely over the text. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna see how as the mask goes across the text, it quickly reveals it. I want this reveal to be a little bit quicker. And I want to easy ease these keyframes. We're gonna go to keyframe assistant, click on easy ease. And that's gonna basically add a little bit of Bezier to an ordinarily linear movement of the mask over the text. It's pretty good. Okay, cool. What I'm going to do is I want this to be a little bit faster. Let's zoom in. And then I'm going to actually go in the graph editor. And then I'm going to bring this. I'm going to stretch the graph over to the left. As you can see, what that's going to do is it's going to add a little bit of pop to that Bezier motion. There we go. It looks amazing. Let's watch that one more time. Perfect. And now last but not least, we're going to add a little bit of motion blur. By doing that, to do that, we're going to go over and click on the enable motion blur button. And then we got to enable motion blur on the specific track that we want to enable the motion blur on. So bam, and then bam. Let's see how it looks. Beautiful, beautiful. I'm just going to add a little bit of motion blur to the motion. Amazing. And you know what I'm going to do? I want to actually make this text smaller. So I'm going to go into transform. I'm going to go into transform. I'm going to decrease the scale. And I'm going to bring this text over here. So this text ends up being more of a lower third than a main title. Let's see how that looks. New York City. Amazing. This text looks so much better than it did before. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Once again, this is Josh Olufemii. You can check out my channel on YouTube entitled Josh Olufemii for more incredible tips in the world of video production. And as always, remember to keep it chill.
Thanks, Josh. Next up, Kelsey Brannon, or Premier Gal as she's known by her fans, engages followers by creating tutorials that, in her words, keep creative adults out of trouble. The brand also works to empower young women in the currently male-dominated film and video industry. So here's Kelsey with her life-changing tip on color matching stock footage. Take it away, gal.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Kelsey here, and I'm the creator of Premiere Gal. On the channel, I create all sorts of really cool Premiere Pro video editing tips, as well as some Photoshop tips, sound, all sorts of different design, creation, whatever you want to call it, types of tutorials. I have a lot of fun doing it, and today I'm excited to share with you one of my favorite tips for matching footage to create a consistent look for your film. So if you're on Envato Elements and you're searching for different stock video clips, and you find two different clips that are great, but they were shot on different cameras by different videographers. And one thing that's really important when you're creating your film is how do you get that consistent look, right? So when you drop these clips in your timeline, you can see that they have really different colors. So what's really cool in Premiere Pro, they have this new color matching tool. So to match the color of one shot to another, you can do it in one click with this tool. Just turn on comparison view, and then you have both of the clips in the program monitor. And on the left, you want the reference clip. So this is the clip that we want to copy the color from to the other clip on the right. And now just make sure to select the clip that you want to copy the color to, then open up the Lumetri color panel, and then go to the section that's called color wheels and matching. And just select apply match, and it will copy the color from the reference clip to the current clip on the right, just like that. And it's done. So this is a really, really quick and easy way to copy the color from one clip to the other. And you can apply that same color match to all the other clips in your timeline. So that's all for this quick tip for you guys today. If you want more in-depth tutorials, head on over to youtube.com/premieregal and go drop a line there. Let me know what you guys want to learn and I'll definitely take a look. So thanks Envato for having me here and I'll see you on YouTube. Bye.
Nathaniel Dodson from Tutvid is up next. Standing by the bold motto of reject mediocrity, Nathaniel has excelled in all things creative since he started his YouTube channel in 2006. As one of the early adopters of the YouTube medium, Nathaniel has been honing his video skills on the platform for 15 years. Here's his tip to help you perfect your seamless transitions.
Well, hey there, and welcome into my little part of this video. My name is Nathaniel Dodson. I run a YouTube channel and a website called Tutvid. Lots of tutorials and other fun videos that you can check out over there. But for today, I want to share with you one of my favorite little tricks for video editing, and that is a helpful little trick to fade together two different clips when you're creating some sort of transition. So in this case, you'll see we're creating a whip transition, or we have created a whip transition, but the two scenes are different in terms of brightness and color and things like that. So this is how I like to use a sort of custom LUT. I guess it's a sort of a LUT, but it's just changing the colors up a little bit to help make that change before the actual transition happens so that it's even more seamless for the end viewer when the time comes to do it. I'm using Adobe Premiere Pro today, so I'm gonna jump in and let's get started right away. Okay, so here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro with the video project that I'm working on here. And you can see it's just a couple shots of a famous prison over in San Francisco. Well, used to be a prison called Alcatraz. And we're just creating this whip pan effect where I go from my outdoor shot to an indoor shot of one of the old cell blocks. And one of the things about this that I want to help out here is the fact that the outdoor shot is a little bit brighter and certainly more colorful, maybe a little less contrasty. And the indoor shot is more moody and heavier on the contrast department, things like that. So this is going to allow us to begin changing the shot here when it is outside to sort of prepare for the whip pan and make it even more seamless of a transition. So I'm going to begin by creating what's called an adjustment layer, and then I can drag that adjustment layer out onto my timeline. And this adjustment layer is going to contain our little color effect. But I want to first zoom in here and just make sure that the adjustment layer is lined up perfectly with the end of my first clip. The first clip is the one that we're going to be performing the color change upon. So we just want to have our adjustment layer lined up with the end of that. Make sure we're not going into the second clip at all. And we are just going to make this change happen only a couple frames before the actual whip pan begins. We don't want this to be something where the footage begins to totally change the way it looks. But what we're going to do is use what's called a Lumetri color effect. So I'm going to punch in Lumetri color. There's the effect I want. I'm going to drag and drop that on my adjustment layer. And here we're going to have a bunch of different parameters that we can change. And we would have to individually animate all of these. This is why I'm using an adjustment layer, because we don't want to have to individually animate all these. So I'm going to begin here with temperature. I'm going to show you, by the way, how we're going to fade this in without having to animate all of this stuff. Let's go ahead and just increase the temperature to crank up some orange into this image. We're also going to play with the tint here. We're going to probably going to push the tint up a little bit, maybe plus 15-ish, 10, 15. And then I want to reduce the exposure a little bit. I'm going to go ahead, just negative 1.5 for exposure, and then I'll boost this contrast up a little bit as well. Maybe darken the shadows just a touch. Highlights, I don't know that I'm gonna mess with anything else here. Saturation, I'm gonna bump it down a little bit, so I do wanna begin the desaturation process before we head into that cell block shot. Now that'd be a ton of stuff to animate, right? All these different parameters, I'd have to line it up over there and just, I don't wanna do that. Because this is up on an adjustment layer, however, we can just animate the opacity of the adjustment layer and bring it up from 0% to 100%. So I'm gonna move over here if I can figure it out and just collapse the Lumetri color. And I'm going to animate my opacity of the overarching adjustment layer. So what we'll do here, and it's gonna be a little tricky here for me as I find the end of the adjustment layer. Premiere is gonna wanna keep snapping me to the end of everything, but I don't want that. Over here, closer to the end of the adjustment layer here, I can pull back just a touch. I will go ahead and just hit the little stopwatch to the left of the word opacity and just leave it there. That's gonna lock us in our finishing point, an opacity of 100%. Shift back a little bit and just reduce the opacity to 0%. I'll highlight these two or just drag a selection over the two keyframes and choose ease out. And there we have a nice smooth animation. Now that final keyframe, I'm gonna shift all the way to the end of my adjustment layer. Remember the end of the adjustment layer? It's aligned with the very end of our first clip in the middle of that whip pan transition. Now you can see as we kind of test this, the footage clearly gets darker and less saturated too early. Well, we can adjust that relatively easily by just, well, we can scroll through here and just double check and make sure. Yeah, I just think it's getting dark a little early. So I'm gonna come over and grab that first keyframe and shift it closer to the end of the clip, which is going to just make the coloration change happen right at the very end of the clip, right as the whip pan is coming into place. It's subtle, but it just helps kind of pull the two shots together and makes a really nice transition in terms of not only the visuals of your whip pan or however you're creating a transition in Premiere, but also just helps ensure you have more of that visual and color continuity shot to shot as you're playing with your transitions. So I'm just gonna go ahead and set an in and out point here so we can just test it real quick, and I'll render this up real quick in Premiere. And there we have it. I can just come up here and make this full screen by hitting the tilde button, and then I can scrub through this, and I can see here as we approach the transition, there we go. The color begins to darken right at the end. You can barely notice it, but it just pulls you through the transition just a little bit more naturally by just darkening that scene that we're exiting and helping it to align more closely with the scene which we're entering into. So there you have it. That is one of my favorite little tips and tricks in terms of working with transitions and video editing. It's really fun. And remember, to make the leap from amateur to pro, it's all about the details. It's all about the little stuff. So it's really important to focus on that stuff. It's the stuff I really need to work on still as well. I'm not sitting here telling you that I'm the pro and you're the amateur. In a lot of ways, I'm still the amateur as well. It's all that little detail stuff that we really want to focus on to push our game to the next level and take all the projects that we're shooting, that we're working on, that we're adding stock footage to, you name it, helping everything mesh and match together. And one great way to ensure nice uniformity throughout your project, in addition to just having everything looking like it's shot the same way, is helping color and contrast from scene to scene, especially when you're transitioning in something like this. It really helps to just make sure that everything is being pulled together at the last minute. So I hope you enjoyed that tip. Thanks so much for giving me a couple minutes of your time. I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching.
That's a wrap on this episode of Turbo Tips. Each of our experts has put together a collection of their favorite items from Envato Elements to help you with your video editing projects, and you can take a look at them all via the links in the description below. While you're down there, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel so we know to produce more content like this. And let us know which creative topic you want us to cover and the YouTubers you'd like to see featured next in the comments. Finally, make sure you check out our Tipmasters channels. You'll find those links in the description too. Catch you next time.